Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about enzyme action. How enzymes carry out a reactions. In the previous class, I told you enzymes are most of the enzymes are protein molecule, and some of the enzymes are made up of RNA. Those enzymes are called ribosomes. So how these enzymes bring about reactions? The carry out reactions. Here, the enzyme actions can be shown by pictorially by a graph. This is a graph, and y-axis potential energy. Let's take on y-axis potential energy, and on the x-axis progression of the reaction. Here, you see the substrate and products. Substrate and products. In any reaction, enzymatic reaction, substrate converts to products, and here this gap indicates activation energy. For the conversion of substrate into product, substrate has to overcome the barrier of activation energy. Activation energy is the energy which is required for the substrate to transform into product. So that is called activation energy. Here you can observe there are two reactions here. In each reaction, substrate converts to products. But here, suppose let's consider this is A reaction and this is B reaction. If you see A reaction is in the presence of enzyme, and B reaction is in the absence of enzyme. So here, in the absence of enzyme, the activation energy barrier, the energy which is need to convert substrate into product, is very high. You can see here. Okay. So without enzyme, for the conversion of substrate into products, we need to input so much energy. So that's why many substrate molecules, they cannot overcome the barrier. So the reaction velocity or speed is very slow. Suppose, for example, if you add enzyme, just in the last class we have discussed one reaction, CO2 plus H2O combines gives rise to H2CO through bicarbonate ions. So this reaction is catalyzed by the carbonic anhydrase. So this is very important reaction. Generally takes place in the cytoplasm of the RBC. So here carbon dioxide combines with water molecule and forms bicarbonate ions. So here, without carbonic anhydrase or in the absence of carbonic anhydrase, the conversion of CO2 plus H2O into H2CO3 is very low, just 200 molecules per hour. But when you add carbonic anhydrase, the velocity of the reaction is very high. So 6 lakh molecules of bicarbonate ions formed in the presence of enzyme just in second, not in hour. So this is the velocity of the reaction. How it is occur? Why? Because here enzyme lowering the activation energy so that the substrate molecule is converting to product molecule very easily. So here, simply in one word, enzymes decreases the activation energy barrier. So that's why the chemical reaction is very fast. So this is how enzyme bring about reactions. So let's see how these enzymes convert substrate into products. I told you on the three-dimensional structure of the enzyme, small pockets or cervix are present. So among these cervix or pockets, one pocket acts as a active site. At this active site, substrate will come and bind to the enzyme. So here, just imagine this is a enzyme structure. Here, just imagine this is an active site. At this active site, substrate will come and bind. So this is called substrate binding to the enzyme. Just imagine, let's write E is the enzyme plus S is the substrate. Now what happens? Substrate bounded with enzyme at the active site and it forms a transient complex that is called ES, enzyme substrate complex. This is transient complex, means it is present only very few minutes. Okay, that is called transient. So after that, this enzyme substrate complex, now it is converted to enzyme product complex EP, and finally this EP product dissociated from the enzyme and forms enzyme plus product. So this is the equation of enzymatic reaction. What happens first? Substrate will come and bind to the enzyme at the active site and it forms enzyme substrate complex. Enzyme substrate complex means the now enzyme tightly bonded with substrate, that is called enzyme substrate complex. Now this enzyme substrate complex, it forms enzyme product complex. That means here the bonded substrate, in the bonded substrate molecule, some chemical bonds broken and new bonds formed. So due to the breakage and formation of new bonds, substrate now converted to product. This is called enzyme product complex. After formation of product, now this enzyme, it has very low affinity for the product. It releases products from the enzyme so that the product will be liberated from the enzyme, from the active site. Now we can get unchanged enzyme. Now this enzyme is ready for the another cycle of enzymatic reactions. So this is how enzymatic reaction takes place. Okay, here the formation of enzyme substrate complex is proposed by two theories. First one is lock and key theory. Lock and key theory, this is proposed by Emil Fischer in 1884. Emil Fischer in 1994. And this lock and key theory mainly states that the active site on the enzyme just looks like a lock. When key fits, how key fits into the lock or lock hole, in the similar way substrate will come and bind to the enzyme at the active site. But later this theory was ruled out by some objections, and later induced fit theory, another theory is induced fit theory, was proposed by Koshland in 1957. So this theory was well accepted by among scientific community. Now this induced fit theory states that the enzyme is not rigid or firmly formed substance, but it highly flexible, so that substrate will bind to the active site. After binding of the substrate to the enzyme, now this enzyme undergo some modifications or changes so that enzyme fully or tightly bind with the substrate. So this is induced fit theory. That means the binding of substrate induces some structural changes or modifications so that the enzyme fully or strongly bind with the substrate. This is called induced flip theory proposed by Oseland in 1957. So this is how enzymatic reaction takes place. In the next class we will discuss about the factors which regulate the enzymatic reactions, after that classification of the enzyme, so that we can complete this chapter. Thank you.